starless, the night may be moonless, but deep in my heart there's a glow. For deep in my heart I know that you love me. You love me because you told me so.
We're here with John Wesley. John Wesley Houston, or is it John Houston Wesley?
It's actually both, depending on what part of the country you're from.
Really?
Yeah.
I like that.
No, John Wesley.
John Wesley, we'll okay. Go. Well, John, you are one of the, actually, you know, I say he was a surprise actor. When I say surprise, because people only saw him as a husband. And then, you know, and then he just went and did this play and just blew us all away. And we began to see that this man really was, you never know what a person's like and until you really get to see them. And that's what I think that we forget to do all our lives. So tell me, you recently have a movie that's getting ready to come out.
You're in it.
Yes, I'm in it. Well, yeah. Can you tell me about the role that you're playing and how one thing turns into another thing? Because you were originally doing something really small and straight,
yes,
something large.
True, true. No, we all came in as day players.
Yes.
And I had one scene in the picture. And I believe it was at the table read.
Yes.
I said the line and the people started laughing. And they wouldn't stop. You remember this?
Yes, just, very funny.
They just laughed. I didn't know why they were laughing, but I knew, boy, I better put it in the camera like that. Mm-hmm. Whatever it was I did, that's what I better do tomorrow when I shoot.
Yes.
So that's what I did. And then the next morning, there's a little more to it. Clifton Powell,
yes,
started an improvisation with me that wasn't written in the text, and I responded to it.
Yes.
And the director took a liking to it. And as a result of it, I think it was early the next morning, he called me in, said he'd call our agent, changed the deal, and upgraded my role to Steve Carter.
Oh,
I actually have a name.
Yes, he has a name, so we're all going to be excited to see. It's called
The Under Shepherd.
The Under Shepherd. Yes. It also stars
Isaiah Washington. Keith David.
Yes.
Clifton Powell.
Yes.
Vanessa Bell Calloway.
And an old actor, Ben Vereen.
No. Bill Cobb.
Cobbs, but Ben Vereen is
Lou Gossett.
Lou Gossett.
You know, award-winning Lou Gossett.
I knew he was an award-winning person.
But they're in the same category.
Yes.
Both great.
So this is exciting that we're going to get to see that this month, so please stay tuned.
That's right.
And also, people don't know that John is also a hero. he's a hero from me, and also from Facebook, because my house got broken into and my neighbor saved the day. Can you tell us about that?
yeah we have a neighbor who's our nosy neighbor, who is actually the godfather.
Yeah, the
who
godfather
keeps watch on the whole neighborhood.
Yes.
And he happened to see some odd looking fellows. He watched them for a while, and then when he saw them disappear, he ran across the street to my house, knocked on the door, said there's somebody in Cheryl's house. I couldn't believe it.
Right.
So I said, oh no, that couldn't be. I didn't even grab anything. I just walked out of my office, walked right over here.
Yes.
And I saw some commotion and I heard some noise. So I went into my best actor's, you know, rage.
And can we hear that?
Hey! Something like that.
Yeah, we have to put a footnote that one of the guys, or maybe a few of them, didn't have a shirt on. And I didn't know this, even though I'm from Harlem. That meant that they must live in the neighborhood. Because men do not walk around without their shirts, unless they're at the beach.
True.
Because,
true. And everybody was in shorts and running clothes. To put a button on this, God is good, because anything could have happened.
Right.
But it didn't.
It didn't.
And fortunately for us, nothing was taken. We caught them right at the right time.
Right.
So that they didn't get away with anything.
And you know what? They tried to take my computer, but they forget an Apple is heavy.
Yes.
And it's locked.
Yes.
You've got to be, they didn't look like they were like
yeah.
geeks to unlock the computer.
Right, right.
It's locked.
No,
you can't get anything.
They were bumbling daytime burglars. who were easily frightened by an old man.
But now we have cameras. We have cameras. We have alarm.
Yes.
We have a whole lot of other things that I'm not mentioning on this thing.
Yes.
But yeah, I'm ready now.
She's ready.
And I will put you on Facebook, YouTube, the web, whatever. And it's probably going to be your third strike, and that will be your last. And you're saying all for that little damn
see,
nothing.
It's not worth it.
Yeah.
Don't come around here, because me and Sam will get you.
Yeah. This is Cheryl Frances Harrington and John Wesley.
That's right.
Now back to you, Bob.
Bobby! Hey! Something like that.